You must understand, I have been here for an eternity. I have built whole cities and watched them decay. Everything returns to sand eventually, and yet we remain. But surely you can build again. Given enough time, everything here decays, except for ourselves. Any action repeated enough times eventually becomes pointless. We appear to have no end to our time, so all actions become meaningless. Those bells were not left as an example of what might be created. They are a reminder and a warning to avoid the burden of inevitable disappointment. There is no end to any of it. Nothing retains any meaning. Great actions ultimately end with failure every single time. The only success possible here comes from menial tasks. This is the only path to happiness, to live at all. The only way to avoid non-existence is to dig. And what of non-existence? I will take you there. I will show you. What's going on here? These are the ones that have chosen nothing. What happened to them? They came here and wait. They come here and wait. After a while, they find it difficult to move. Later, they are unable to move at all. Eventually, they cannot communicate, and I believe they are no longer aware of anything at all. Such is the fate of those that chose nothing. I would not wish this on anyone. I suggest that you choose to dig. Why do they all group together like that? I do not know. I've seen it happen with many. They simply give up the will to continue living and come join a group like this to cease to be. Perhaps they feel a stronger purpose treading a path that is laid before them by others. Perhaps this non-existence feels like it has meaning when chosen with many others. There are many groups like this scattered throughout the desert. How does it happen? How do they choose nothing? It is not as much of a choice as a lack of action. Refrain from any action long enough and you will end up like them. So I either dig for eternity or face practical non-existence for eternity. I can't say I'm overjoyed with either option. What is out there in the desert? There's nothing more. Travel too far and the heat becomes so intense you cannot see. If you go too far, you may never come back. I will leave you now to consider and make your choice. I hope that you will choose to dig. If you do, come back and see me again. If not... Huh. Really? The end. Not the end, he says. Do you want to quit? No. We can choose for it not to end. This person does not respond in any way. Though they are moving, there does not appear to be any life in them. If I go too far, I may never come back. After wandering in the desert for an indeterminate amount of time, the heat becomes unbearable, and the land itself appears to lose its physicality. Tree. I think I can hear the tree. 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 Tree? Tree! I have to get out of here before I lose my mind. Alright, let's go back. Although I wonder what it might be like to lose our mind. Let's lose our mind. See what happens. Sand, sand, sand. I have to get out of here. I have to go back. Whoa. Oh my god. You wanna quit? No. 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 Can't even look at anything out here. Yeah, let's go back. Tree. Sand, sand, sand. I wonder if if you stand here for a while, or hover, whatever. I wonder if you become like them. You are back. I presume this means you have chosen to dig. Is that really all there is to do here? It is the only choice we have. We either dig, or we end up like those brain-dead souls you just saw. I really thought the game was ending before. Is there no way to escape from this place? Is everyone here really satisfied with this existence? There have been others like you. Many come to me hoping for answers. I could not help any of them. Some of them wandered off into the desert and were not seen since. Others chose nothing. Where did they go to? Does this desert ever end? No. I have traveled in all directions for an eternity and found nothing. Eventually, I returned to where I had started and remained, as this was the one place I felt I belonged. Place you belonged. Is there a way to escape through the sand? How far down have you dug? I have dug as far as possible to dig. The bedrock below the sand is stronger than the rocks we use for our tools. To try and break it is futile. There is nowhere to go. Well then, assuming I want to dig, how do I even do this? I didn't wake up here holding a shovel. Everyone here has made their own. There are a few instinctual pieces of knowledge that even the least intelligent here possess. How to create a shovel, how to dig a hole, and how to fill it in again. So, are you saying that if I don't know how to make a shovel, I am the least intelligent being here? That is not what I mean, but it certainly makes you an anomaly here, more so than myself. I do not doubt your intelligence, but I question your sanity. Well, if digging holes and filling them in again for all eternity is considered sane here, I think I will happily call myself a madman. Very well. So, yes? How do I make a shovel? Ah, you have chosen to dig. Not yet. I just want to keep my options open and have as many choices as possible. Which is two, apparently. A shovel is very simple to make. Simply take a branch of any tree, a flat rock, and tie them together with grass. Of course, trees, rocks, and grass seem to be the only objects in this desert. Will you dig? Dig. That word doesn't even seem real anymore. Yes, I'll dig. I'll dig my way right out of this place. I would not recommend that. Others have tried. They get so far down and eventually give up, becoming frozen far down in the bedrock. There is really nothing down there. I'm going to try anyway. There must be a way out of here. Though I admire your spirit, I am also saddened by it. I have been here forever, and have tried everything. I am speaking honestly when I say your only chance for happiness is to dig. That may be true, but I at least need to know this for myself. I have to try. Very well. I wish you luck. If we ever meet again, I hope that you manage to find peace in this world. Farewell. Wherever they are, this person does not seem to know more than anyone else here. How do I make a shovel? You just need to tie a flat rock to a stick with some strong grass. There are piles of rocks throughout the desert. All the other diggers collect them. Where should I dig? That is entirely up to you. The desert is vast and there are unlimited places for digging. Well, if I'm going to do this, Maybe I'll go back to where I began here. Very well. Goodbye, then. I am sorry I could not be of more help. I do hope you find peace here. Okay, the music was getting loud. I don't want to destroy the one interesting creation in this place. I'll take a piece from one of the other trees. This tree is a bit too small. I'll try one of the bigger ones. Any more options? I found the pyramid you mentioned. Did you get an answer? Sort of. There was someone living in there who seemed to know more about this place. I'm not sure I believe any of it, though. There is no one in there. The pyramid is solid and speaks in a strange language. No, it's... Oh, never mind. Any idea where I can find a flat rock for a shovel? There are a few piles of them behind you a little ways. Yeah, I've seen them. Do you know where I can find any grass? Grass grows near caves. Thanks. I have to say I'm a bit surprised to get a useful answer. Useful answer? Your answer. It was useful. Useful answer? Oh, never mind. I'll snap a piece of a branch off. I already have a piece of a tree for my shovel. Maybe we should dig here and make that hole bigger. There's someone down there. This might be one of those who try to dig down too far. Hello? Hello? They must be brain dead like that group out in the desert. There's nothing I can do for them. If I climb down there, I'll never get back out again. Well, we're gonna dig our own hole. Let's get a rock pile. Or a rock from a rock pile. These must be the rocks collected by the diggers to make shovels. I'll take one with me. Alright, now we need grass. See if any new options. Some grass. Can we put that together? I can't do anything with the branch yet. I need to find some grass to tie this to the rock. This rock should work as the shovel blade. I still need some grass to tie it to the branch. Let's go get it. I'll take a piece of the grass. This grass seems almost petrified, too. Is there no life in this place at all? Now I have everything I need to make this shovel. I'll just combine these together. I don't know why I couldn't say that sentence. Now I suppose I dig? I don't need another piece of grass. I already have a branch for my shovel. The place I began. If I'm going to dig, it may as well be in here. Right. This could be the place to dig. I was trying to click that. Yeah. Perhaps the water has weakened the rock. I might as well try to dig here. Meaning there. The cave floor, weakened by the water, breaks away with a little effort. Progress is slow, but aided by the continual flow of water. I wonder if we stayed in the cave and did nothing, we'd become a brain-dead person, probably. I had made a choice that felt real to me. Whether my hand was forced or guided by a higher power, whether there were other choices possible or not, none of this mattered anymore. I had ventured on a path that was now mine. It was bound to me, and I to it. This path was my own, and nothing could change that. I would follow it to the end, and know that I had lived. Okay, Adventure Game Studio. We have deleted scenes to coming up. His shovel. Okay, now for the deleted scenes. Okay, now for the deleted scenes. What's odd is I have to record this with Bandicam. The regular game was recorded with Shadowplay, NVIDIA Shadowplay, in desktop mode. For some reason, you play this from Steam, and you choose, instead of playing the main game, you choose, you know, there's a configuration tool, and then there's deleted scenes. So you choose this, but once I do that, it just stops the recording. It's weird, but yet I am able to record with Bandicam, so hopefully this turns out all right. This is my second time, though, playing through scene one, unfortunately. Not blind for scene one. In which the player finds another occupant somewhere in the cave. This idea was cut, as it seemed to work better starting off alone in the cave, as well as raising too many questions about how everyone came to be there, which didn't add much to the game. So, pretty interesting how deleted scenes with commentary, with text commentary. I like it. I think more games should do this. Can't get info. Can only speak. Who are you? I am lost. Can you help me? Help Well, I was hoping you could help me. Who are you? I'm not really sure of that. Who are you? I am lost. I feel it. Okay, hi, lost. what do you feel? The feeling of the dream, the memory of light. Light? Please, you have to help me get back. Get back? What do you mean? Get back where? Where are we now? I feel it. The memory of the dream. I have to get back. Dream? Tell me about your dream. I don't have the dream anymore. Only the memory of the dream. What memory? The feeling of a bright light. The sounds of singing in the sky. Singing? Singing in the sky? Music. I dreamt music. The sound of life. The sound of life. Who are you? How did you get here? I woke here. There was nothing before. Only the memory of the light. I woke up in darkness and confusion. I can't hear the singing anymore. I am lost. I feel it. I'm going to find a way out of here. You should come with me. There is no way out. There's only darkness and confusion. Okay, scene 2. In which the player comes across two more unhelpful individuals in a desert. This conversation didn't really add anything further to the game world, and also didn't fit in with the dig-do-nothing choice. Aha! You go that way and it quits out. Okay. Alright. Just curious what would happen. I figured we were supposed to go this way. Digger. Digger. There was another person here in the desert. They appear to be the first person here that is not digging a hole. Another person not digging a hole. What are you doing here? We are waiting. Both of you? We are waiting. Who are you waiting for? We are waiting for no one. We wait for no one. Why? Why are you waiting then? We wait to live. We live to wait. That sounds familiar. The others here all seem to be digging. Yes, they dig. But you are not digging? No. We don't dig. I had hoped to find someone like you. You have found another way to live? Not by digging? We live to wait. We wait to live. But what happens after? After? Yes, after waiting, when the waiting is over. The waiting is not over. We live to wait. We wait to live. You wait to live. We wait to live. Stop it. This is not living. No, this is not living. This is not waiting. You are interrupting our waiting. I am? Interrupting our waiting. I see. I will let you be then. Please do. Thank you. Well, goodbye then. I am leaving. Okay. Interesting though. I like it. Scene 3. Originally, the hermit in the pyramid was to have a giant hourglass inside. This would continuously rotate slowly so that the sand never settled. This animation and dialogue was cut as the conversation was getting too long anyway. It was the longest conversation. Machine? What is that machine over there? It measures time. But it keeps turning. How can it measure anything? This is the most accurate way to measure time here. It has no beginning and no end. It is continually moving, but to measure it is meaningless. I built this machine as a reminder of this. But you said you were here before the others. Surely that time could be measured? I could choose to apply a number to it, but this would be of no use. With no end to our existence, measuring it is absurd. And finally, scene 4. In an earlier planned ending, the player would dig a trench from the cave into the desert. The ending would show a river forming in the desert, gradually working through the rock on its own. This is the draft dialogue from that original sequence. I had made my choice, and I waited. Time passed, and I waited some more. The river grew, and still I waited. The rocks broke, and still I waited. Eternity came and went, and still I waited. An eternity of waiting meant nothing to me, for I knew the promise of a new life. I could sense the change. I had dug the trench. The rest was up to the river. Okay, and there we have it. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Hope to see you guys in what would probably be a longer Let's Play. I hope you enjoyed. I found it very interesting. It's like a somewhat similar to real life. You can do pointless tasks and live your life, or you could just sit around and do nothing and degenerate into what? Being homeless? Being, I don't know, lethargic? Being, I don't know, having no purpose in life. So even if your purpose in life makes no sense, maybe it's better to have a nonsensical purpose in life than to have no purpose in life. Something to think about. Not sure if I agree with it or not. I couldn't really say. They both seem depressing ways to live your life. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. See you guys in another Let's Play, and always seek adventure.